Good morning all. Today I am discussing about the cost analysis. So before that, we know about what do you mean by production cost. See, the cost, production cost play an important role to a firm or entrepreneur or enterprises because it determines the profit ratio of the entrepreneur. So why do you mean by production cost? See, the cost means, production cost, the cost means the expenses incurred by the producer to produce a commodity. That means it includes implicit and explicit expenses, that is called production cost. So when we know about the types of cost, we divide the total cost into two groups. One is short term cost and long term cost. That means in the short term, some costs are fixed and some costs are varies to increase the output. But in long term, there will be no difference between fixed cost and variable cost. All costs are variable cost. For example, I will give some examples about the short term cost, like insurance premium. They have to keep fixed cost insurance premium, they have to pay insurance premium, and they can increase the transportation cost and raw material charges, etc. And in the long run, all costs are variable costs. Then come to the short term cost. There are seven costs. Seven costs are arises in the short term. They are total fixed cost, total variable cost, total cost, always fixed cost, always variable cost, always cost, and marginal cost. Then let me start from the first cost, total fixed cost. See, total fixed cost. Total fixed cost means those costs which are fixed at all levels of output. That means as the level of output increases, the cost will remain constant, it will not decrease. They remain constant. These costs are called fixed cost, that is total fixed cost. Then how can we determine the total fixed cost? It can be determined by using a formula, that is TC minus TBC. That means when we deduct total variable cost from the total cost, we get total fixed cost. For example, the example for fixed cost: insurance premium, rent of building, then wages, salary to the permanent workers, etc. Then second type is total variable cost. So total variable cost means those costs which varies, that means which changes according to the output. That means as the level of output increases, these costs are also increases. When the output increases, these costs are also decreases. Those costs are called total variable cost, that means variable cost. Then how can we determine this? The total variable cost can be determined by deducting total fixed cost from the total cost. By deducting total fixed cost from the total cost, we get total variable cost. Then come to the third type, that is total cost. The total cost, which is the sum? This is sum. It is the sum of fixed cost and variable cost. Fixed cost and variable cost is called total cost. That means by adding total fixed cost and total variable cost, we get total cost. That means TFC plus TBC is equal to TC. Then we can study the relationship between total fixed cost, total variable cost, and total cost through the diagram. Then consult the diagram. In the above diagram, as the output increases, the total fixed cost remains constant. That is, it is parallel to horizontal axis, y-axis. Then, as the level of output increases, both TBC and TC, that is total variable cost and total cost, also increases. But the total cost is always above the total variable cost. And one thing we should observe, that the TBC curve is origin from zero. It is origin from zero, but TC is not origin from zero, because when the output is zero, there will be some fixed cost. When the output is zero, there will be zero. The total variable cost is zero. But when the output is zero, we can see some fixed cost. That's why we can see the total fixed cost and total cost.
Then come to the fourth type,
that is
average fixed cost. Average means per unit.
So average fixed cost means
the cost of per unit of fixed factor.
Cost of per unit of fixed factor,
that is fixed input.
How can we open this? The average fixed cost can be opened by dividing total fixed cost
from the unit of factors, that is unit of input.
That is TF divided by Q.
Here Q implies units of input, that is units of factors of production.
Then average variable cost.
The average variable cost means average means per unit. It is the cost of per unit of variable input.
Cost of per unit of variable input.
Then it can be calculated by dividing the total variable cost from the unit of variable inputs. Units of variable inputs.
That is TVC divided by Q. Then average cost.
So average means it is sum of average fixed cost and average variable cost. We can also say
it is sum of average fixed cost and average variable cost.
And another meaning is average cost means it is the cost of per unit of total cost of production.
Cost of per unit of total cost of production.
How can we open this?
It can be calculated as
TC divided by Q. That means
total cost
divided by total cost divided by units of input. Units of input.
Or we can also call, we can also convert it as AFC plus ABC. AFC plus ABC. We can get average cost.
Let me see the relationship between
average cost,
average variable cost and average fixed cost.
Previous total cost of input.